Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, I'm going to show you how to write a script in Automator so that you can snap windows to positions on your screen. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Join us and get exclusive content at MacMost.com/Patreon. So I know there are third-party tools that allow you to snap windows to different parts of your screen. You can do the same thing in Automator, and with a little scripting you can make it quite advanced. So let's start off here in Automator. I'm going to create a new document and I'm going to make it a quick action. Now the only thing I'm going to add to it is the ability to write a JavaScript script. So I'm going to use run JavaScript and drag that over into here. And everything we're going to do is going to be in here. I'm going to expand this space a bit. We're going to put all of our code in here. The workflow is not going to receive any input. We're not going to have any selected text or anything like that. And it's going to work in any application. Now to get started, I'm going to get the current app. So the one that's currently running, because that's the one we're going to change the position of the window for. So we're going to put two lines here. App equals application.currentApplication. It's a function. And app.includes standard editions. This is typical of starting a JavaScript or JXA script in Automator. Now we want to set the position for the frontmost window for this app. So to do that, it's pretty simple. I'm going to do app.windows and in brackets 0 for the first window. And I'm going to set the bounds equal to a boundary object, which has four properties. X, so we'll say X is 0 for the upper left-hand corner with Y 0 as well. And then we'll do width and we'll set it to something like say 300 pixels and height. We'll set that to say 500 pixels. And all this will do then is set the boundary for the current window to 00 to 300, 500. We can get rid of the return input there. We don't need that and we could just try this script out by hitting the run button. Since the frontmost window is Automator itself, it should affect Automator. And you can see sure enough it set it there. Now what's interesting here is you can just change these numbers to whatever you want and you can be done. You can create a variety of different Automator scripts that can set things to the top left corner, the top right corner, the left third, the right two thirds, whatever you need. But let's get a little more complex and make a script that's more versatile. So I'm going to put a little window that pops up and asks you for where you want the window positioned. So I'm going to do a variable called area choices and I'm going to set it equal to a list of choices. We'll make those our three choices for now. Now I'm going to get the user choice using app.choose_from_list. You have to use a reference to an app in order to bring up choose from list. So we'll set the first parameter to be area choices. Then we'll do some more options here. We'll do width, prompt, something like where, and we'll close that off. Comment this line out now. So it doesn't actually do anything. I'll hit run and you can see it comes up with this list here and I can select one, hit OK, or I can double click one and the result is put into area. So what I could do here and say if area equals, and I could say left third, and we need to do double equals there to test. Then we can do something like this and else if area equals right two thirds, then we can do the same thing. So I'm going to copy and paste, but we'll change the numbers. So we'll have it start at 300 pixels and be say 600 pixels wide. So now it'll choose between these two. So if I run this now and I do left third, it's going to do that. If I run it again and I do right two thirds, you can see it puts it there. It's not putting it exactly at one third or exactly at the right two thirds because all I'm doing is just guessing using these numbers. So let's stop guessing and actually get the real values. So here's the code I'm going to use to get the pixel dimensions of the screen. And it's going to work regardless of how many displays I've got. So let's walk through it. First line is going to run a shell script. And the shell script is going to do the special little system profiler here to actually get the text about all of our displays and graphics card. It's the same thing that you will see if you go to About This Mac and then go to System Information and then look at your display information. And the text it's going to return is going to be this text. I'm actually going to show it to you. I'm going to paste in this return here. So I'll run this. I'm going to have to just choose one here. It doesn't matter which one. And we'll see every line here. You could see what it looks like. It does look like what you get in About This Mac. So what we want to do then is we want to put that in display info, split it every time we see the text UI looks like. So let's look at that again here. And we could see here the text UI looks like appears three times, one for each screen. And it kind of kicks off the information we want about the screen. The resolution is great, but if we have the resolution set to be something different, which I do on my Retina display, then it's not going to match. Like UI looks like is the same as resolution here for the first and for the second, but for the third screen you can see the resolution is much higher and I've set the UI looks like to be smaller. So that's the real resolution of the screen is 1280 by 720 and it's what we want to use in our script to figure out what's half or one third of the width of the screen. So every time it sees this it's going to divide this up into a different item in the array using split. And the split command is basically going to make sure that there's one element that's before the first display. Second element is going to be the first display. Third element is going to be second display. And fourth element is going to be the third display. And we get all the text from UI looks like right after that all the way down. Now notice here it says main display yes. It only says that on the third display. That's key. That will allow us to identify the third display as the main display. So after we work with all of that, we're going to loop through those four items. We're going to look for the text main display. If it's greater than -1, that means it exists in this item. It's only going to be there for the last item. And in that case, it's going to run this. It's going to split all that text up with spaces. And after UI looks like, we get 1280 space X space 720. So that first item represented by 0 is the width. Third item represented by 2 is height. The X would be the one in between that. So it's 0, 1, 2, 1280, 720 put into display width, display height. Great, we're done. So we break and what we should have here is a correct display width and display height. And we'll test it. So I will put that in a return. I will run. Doesn't matter which one we pick. And you can see here the return value 1280 comma 720. Hooray, we've figured out the display width and display height. Now we can use that down here. So we can say, okay, X and Y upper left hand corner, but the width, let's set that to display width divided by 3, or better yet, multiply by 0.333. And the height, we'll set that to display height, so full height. That'll be the left third. Then we'll go and we'll say the right two-thirds, well we'll start that at display width times 0.333, so one-third over, and then we will go a display width times 0.6667, two-thirds of the width. And the height will do display height. So now when we run this, we go and say left third gives us the left third. We run it again, right two-thirds gives us the right two-thirds. So that's exactly what we want. So far so good. We're going to run into a problem when we try to run this as a script on anything but Automator. We are going to need another way to tell what app is actually the Frontmost app, because when we run this as a service it's going to still think that the Automator process is the Frontmost app. So we'll keep this here but we'll add some more lines. And this is what this looks like here. We're going to get the front app name by going to Application System Events, looking at the processes there, and then we will use processes whose frontmost is true. It's a little weird syntax here, but it actually gives us the name of the frontmost process. We actually have to look at the first element in the array that's returned and get the name of it. So the value then should be returned. Let's try it out. Ah, Automator. So that's good. So that's working. The front app is then going to be application front app name. You would think that you'd be able to take this off and get the front app right there in that line, but it doesn't work. So now we have the front app. So great. So instead of setting the app, the main app, the one that's running, which would be the Automator process, we're going to set the front app here. And it should work the same in Automator. Great, it does. Now let's save this script. Save, and we'll call it window position. And it's saved as a quick action. So now it should appear if we go to anything, the application you're running, and there's under services window position. So let's try it out in another app, like say Safari. So here we are in Safari. I can go to Safari and I go to services and window position. It's going to give us that little dialog there. I'll say left third. And there it goes. It sets it to the left third. The great thing is I can open up another window here in Safari, and now this is the frontmost window. So when I go services, window position, I can say right two thirds, and it locks this window to the right two thirds of the screen. So next I can go in system preferences and I can do keyboard, shortcuts, app shortcuts, and I can add one. And I'll say all applications window position, and I'll make the keyboard shortcut something like shift F1. And there you go. So now I can go into Safari here. Let's move this window around. And if I look under services, I can see window position is shift F1. So I don't have to choose that anymore. I can just do shift F1. It'll pop up and I can set the position of the window. Now what you're going to get every time you use this script is you're going to get a little dialog that asks for permission. I had already run the script on Safari, so you didn't see it. But let's try it on maps here. I'll go to services here, or I can just use shift F1. And it's going to say maps wants access to system events, all of that. So you say okay. And now I can use the script. Now that's the basics. You also want to add another else statement for the top left corner. So in that case, you may want to have, say, half the display width and half the display height. Note that display height doesn't take into account the menu bar height at the top. So you may want to subtract some or work with that just to get things exactly as you want. And of course, if you do have multiple screens and you want to set things to be in different areas of different screens, you can work with negative values or values that are greater than the display height or display width to position it on the different screens where you want it. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.